In this lesson, we will start with a new web application to manage contacts. This application will store these contacts in the database, and we're going to call it Phonebook. Let's then create the new application, call it Phonebook, and let's change the icon of the application. Select the icon here. You'll find this icon in the lesson resources, as well as all the files that we're going to use in this lesson. Let's create the application, and now we need to create a module for our application. Unlike the blank module we used in the previous lesson, we are going to use this responsive module because this module has a UI template by default that is prepared to work on desktop and mobile devices like tablets and smartphones. So let's go ahead and create the module. And you will notice that we already have here a few elements created in our module, a couple of web flows, a web screen for the homepage. We'll go into detail about all these elements in the lessons ahead. For now, let me just walk you through the homepage and to show you that when we create a new web screen in our module, you will notice that we already have a header, a place to put a title for the screen, the main content area, and a footer, and we'll have a menu and so on. So we have already this UI template to create our application. Okay, so we have our module created. We said that we're going to store these contacts in the database, so we will need a way to store this information. In OutSystems, to store information, in this case our contacts, we need to create an entity, and an entity is just a table in the database. To create an entity, we'll go here into the Data tab, right-click the Entities folder, and select Add Entity. And I'm going to call it Contact. Now, we need to define what information we are going to store about a contact. And the information we want to store about the contact is defined by adding attributes to the entity. An attribute is a column in the database table. By default, you'll notice that the platform already adds here an ID attribute that allows you to uniquely identify a contact. This is also known as a primary key. So let's add a couple attributes to the contact entity. And the first one will be the name of the contact. And the next one, the phone number. Okay, before we continue to display these contacts here in the homepage, I want to make sure that I have actual contacts in the database. So I want to bootstrap this entity with some data. And actually this data, let me show you, this data is present in this Excel file. You'll see that we have here a bunch of contacts with their name and their phone number. And we're going to bootstrap this information into the contact entity. So let me just close here the Excel file. And to bootstrap the data, I'm going to right-click the entity. And on the Advanced menu, I'm going to select this option, Create Action to Bootstrap Data from Excel File. And I'm going to select here the contacts Excel file. This is the mapping between the columns in the Excel file and the attributes in the contact entity. It's all okay, let's proceed. And there we have it. Before we continue, let me make sure that these contacts are bootstrapped in the database. And to do this, we will need to publish our application for the first time. In this publish, the platform created a table for the contact entity in the database and bootstraps the data that we have on the Excel file into that table in the database. And on the next lesson, we will see how to fetch the contacts from the database and show them here on the screen. That's it.